Hi,
my name is Jonathan Benator. I'm a partner at Lazega Johanson, and I specialize in representing community associations. One of the questions that we often receive is whether a board of directors for a community association can legally and effectively use self-help to remedy a covenant violation. This is also known as exercising the right of abatement. You may think of this as the association's right to mow somebody's lawn that refuses to do so. But let us start by taking a step back. We know that self-help could, depending on a number of factors that we will discuss later, possibly be used to remedy a covenant violation. But what are covenant violations, and how do they arise? When you buy into a community association, whether it is a large subdivision with tennis courts and a pool, a high-rise condo in Midtown, or an artsy townhome development near a park, you are agreeing to be bound by a set of covenants. These covenants are recorded in the land records and bind you and your property. They often include a list of use restrictions that dictate what you can and cannot do with the property. For instance, your covenant may say specifically that you cannot place a grill on your deck or put up a basketball hoop in your driveway. It could also say something more general, like you cannot do anything that would disturb your neighbors or create a nuisance, as determined by the board in its sole discretion. In addition, most covenants will include a requirement that people who live in the community maintain their lot or unit to a certain standard and that they seek approval from the board of directors before making any architectural changes to the property. When someone violates these covenants, the community association's remedies, acting through the board of directors, may include the right to use self-help. But you need to check your community's governing documents for authority first. The language in your documents may be clear, or it could be somewhat ambiguous. This comes up a lot when a board looks to tow somebody's car for parking somewhere they are not supposed to. Ideally, your governing documents would state very clearly that your community association has the right to tow vehicles and spell out the process for doing so. Alternatively, your covenants may be a little bit more ambiguous and require some interpretation and analysis by an attorney. Once you have established that a violation exists and that the board has the authority to exercise self-help to remedy that violation, the next question is whether that remedy has been time-barred by the statute of limitations. In other words, the question is whether the board took too long to enforce its covenants. You may not be aware of this, but there are laws that set limitations on bringing different kinds of legal actions. These are called statutes of limitations. For our purposes, I can tell you that the statute of limitations for enforcing a covenant violation is 2 years. That seems simple enough. And if you're within this 2-year window, you should be fine. Of course, there are things to consider that may effectively extend this window of time or shorten it. We regularly address these issues with our clients. Finally, assuming that you have the authority to use self-help and are within the applicable statute of limitations, the question now becomes, should you use self-help? This is where you have to think about the practical side of things and the real-world implications of using self-help without a court order. As my wife likes to tell her oldest son, just because you can do something doesn't mean you should do it. And that's actually really good advice for adults too. If the covenant violation can be easily remedied, meaning that both time and expense are nominal, and the owner is not going to protest the use of self-help, then it is an easy decision for the board. Go ahead and exercise the right of abatement if you are so inclined. A common scenario where this comes up is when a delinquent homeowner has abandoned their property, and consequently the property has fallen into a state of disrepair. I'm reminded of a situation where during the height of the Zika scare, someone's pool had become a breeding ground for mosquitoes. The owner was unresponsive and unwilling to address the problem. I advised the board that after proper notice, they could drain the pool to prevent the spread of mosquitoes that could potentially carry the Zika virus. The board was also able to charge the cost back to the owner. On the other hand, the covenant violation cannot be easily remedied, meaning the time or expense will be great, and you think the owner is going to protest the exercise of self-help, then it is a harder decision for the board to make. The board may want to think twice before exercising self-help in those situations. Let me tell you a story about an owner that painted his garage door a color that was not approved by the community's architectural control committee. Among other arguments that the owner had made, he was adamant that the garage door looked nice and that the board had no authority to tell him to repaint it. If the board tried to exercise self-help in that scenario, The owner may very well have come out onto the driveway and demanded that the painters leave, and even threatened to call the police for trespass. The painters, not wanting to get into an altercation with the owner, may decide to simply leave. Also, even if the police are there, you cannot really be sure how the police will react when faced with a homeowner that is yelling and screaming that people are trespassing on his or her property. In general, the police are not going to enforce private covenants against individual owners without a court order. If we know it could be messy going in, it may be more prudent to file a lawsuit and obtain a court order. This gives the owner an opportunity to vet his or her legal challenges in front of a judge. Also, the court order can be given to the police to enforce. Now that you better understand how abatement works, I want to leave you with one final thought, and here it is. Remember to always exercise compassion in abatement actions. We do not always know a person's circumstance, whether sick or elderly or experiencing a loss of job or income. Not everyone ignores covenants as a stubborn act of defiance against the association. So it is a good idea to communicate regularly with us before exercising abatement. It can help you exercise abatement in a way that is legal, constructive, and with a fair opportunity for due process to the owner regarding his or her home. Thank you.